you cannot force it. It's a light within you, a flicker. And the analogy could be like the gas that rises and touches the flicker, and the whole gas gets enlightened. The flicker is awake all the time and watching. Then the whole thing becomes the truth. Truth is very different from what we know as truth. It's a new dimension by which we know this is the truth and this is not the truth. You can ask any questions when you are connected with your spirit. Ask any question. Ask a question about me. You can ask a question about Christ, about Moses, about God. Ask any question. And when the answer is yes, you will get cool breeze coming into it. If you ask any negative questions, you will lose your vibrations. Might get tingling, might get heat. Because now your computer is connected with the Absolute, and the rapport has been established of the truth. This is a new awareness you get by which you become aware of truth, which is the vibratory awareness. Through vibrations a child also can know. There are many children who are born realized, and they know where is the Kundalini. They know. They will tell you where is the Kundalini. It's the truth. Because they know the truth, for that you don't need too much of mental development. They are very dignified. They understand it better than many elderly people and people who are placed very highly in life. Christ has already said that rich men are not going to enter into the kingdom of God. He's already said, because they are ready. But I would say even those who think they know a lot, all knowing, they will not enter. Because they do not want to enter. They know everything. They do not want to enter inside. They want to carry their mind everywhere. They want to carry their car inside the hall. How will they enter inside? They are not willing to keep their mind outside, because they have always depended on that mind, which has given them nothing. But to achieve spirit, you have to come there egolessly to receive. The light of your being is going to enlighten the whole thing, your temple. And when this light comes in, when this light shines in you, then you can feel your collective consciousness, you can feel it, the cool breeze of the spirit manifesting through. Is described in the Bible in very short but deep. But Adi Shankaracharya has written such a big book on this called as Saundarya Lahari or Chaitanya Lahari. It is not easy to talk about all these in such a short time. He wrote treatises of philosophy. Great personality he was. Called as Viveka Churamani. First of all, he gave the conscience the call. Where is your conscience and all that? Viveka Churamani. Then he wrote many books, and ultimately he wrote Saundarya Lahari. In that he says, it's only the description of the beauty of my mother I can describe. And into all details he has described nothing but the mother. Her fingers, her hands, her movements and everything, and what he saw, how the vibrations flew in her, every words that she spoke. You have to read that book to understand Sahaja Yoga. It's very clearly given all these things. As I told you the other day, William Blake also has written about Sahaja Yoga very clearly. But unless and until you have realization, you cannot know the truth. So he is the truth, Sat. Then he is Chit, is attention. is the attention. Your spirit is the attention. Attention of what? God is attentive to you through your spirit. And when your attention is enlightened by Him, that means you come in the attention of God. You are looked after by God. All His powers flow into you. All His protection comes to you. You'll be amazed, there will be here Sahaja Yogis who will tell you how they avoided accidents, what happened after accidents, and miraculously how people are saved. It is nothing new to me. This is the minimum that can happen to a person. This is the minimum of minimum, because all the angels, they take charge. You are on the stage. The angels are there to look after you. And you really start gradually feeling the presence of that blessing, which is the attention of God. So He is the Chit, Sat-Chit and Anand. He is the joy. He is the joy. Because God is joy. He created this universe not to make us serious and unhappy and sulky. See how many flowers, how many beautiful things, how many colors, what He has created for us. For us to enjoy, He has created all this world, not to indulge into nonsense, into filth, into dirt. The dirt of the mind, the sin, the filthy ideas. But to have a clean heart and to have a clean morality within us, He created this beautiful world for us to enjoy. Without that you cannot enjoy. You cannot enjoy. Unless and until you have a clean morality within you, you cannot enjoy yourself. And that joy is your own, once you get your realization. This joy is the compassion and grace of God. When the Kundalini first rises, through a one small little thread, she touches the Brahmarandra here. Just one thread, she opens, then the grace, the joy. Because here is the seat of Sadashiva, here is the seat of your spirit. When it touches the speed, that seat, the flow of the grace starts coming on your sympathetic nervous system and you feel relaxed. First thing happens, you feel relaxed. It's the grace. Only one thread has reached. And then the flow that is flowing today, this one is the Brahma, is the power of God flowing through you. This is what you have to get.